Good morning, students. Last video we have discussed washing machine and automotive application. Today we will see the next topic, smart car system application. What is smart car? It is a type of car like devices with an integrated circuit chip embedded in it. The integrated circuit chip may be a microprocessor with a memory or a single memory circuit. So, a smart card is a card that allows data to be shared, stored, and manipulated. The size and shape of this card is a tiny rectangular piece of a card. These cards are very convenient to use in our wallet. Otherwise, back pocket. These cards are mainly used in banks, educational institutions, shops, offices to perform different transactions. Thus, these cards are accessible in different forms and sizes. These cards have allowed the safety as well as convenience of any transactions. The technology used in these cards will help the users to store personal details. These cards will vary based on the following dimension. The first, we are considering the memory. Its memory ranges from 1 to 16 kilobytes. Then processor speed. The processor speed ranges from 4 to 16 megahertz. Then interaction, that is a physical contact, proximity and radio type. Then software, the software used in this type of card is operating system and installed applications. For example, the payment card like debit card and credit card are issued by banks as well as commercial organization. In hospital, these cards are used to store the details of patients. Then electronic benefit transfer or EBT cards are mainly used for the allotment of government benefits. These are mainly used for access control in government authorities, educational institutions, etc. Once again, I repeat, a smart card is called chip card or integrated circuit card. It is a pocket size type card with embedded integrated circuits which can process data. This card can receive input which is processed by way of the ICC, that is integrated circuit card application, and delivered as an output. A smart card is a plastic card embedded with a computer chip that stores and transacts data between users. Smart card enhanced systems are in use today in several key applications such as healthcare, banking, entertainment, and transportation. The card data is transacted via a reader connected to a computing system. Smart card improves the convenience and security of any transaction. The card provides a tamper-proof storage of user and account identify vital components of the system security for the exchange of data throughout virtually any type of network. The smart cards protect against a full range of security threat. A smart card resembles a credit card in size and shape, but inside it is a completely different. The inside of a smart card usually contains an embedded microprocessor. The microprocessor is under a gold contact pad on one side of the card. Smart card may have up to 8 kilobyte of RAM, 346 kilobyte of ROM, 256 kilobyte of programmable ROM, and a 16 bit of microprocessor. The smart card uses a serial interface and receives its power from the external source like a card reader. The next slide shows the architecture, smart card architecture. Generally, the architecture of a smart card includes three elements like IO system, CPU or central processing unit, then memory. Let's see one by one. IO system. IO system of the smart card include specific components to execute the functions of the input and output. It includes an internal logic circuit to work in combination with the microprocessor for controlling the timing as well as data flow that is transferred into the memory of the card. The physical structure of this card can easily interface to a card reader, and it is connected to the host computer to exchange the data. The group of physical interfaces mainly depends on the kind of cards, such as contactless and contact type. Smart card contact interface can be contact pad under which lies a chip, and the contactless smart card interface mainly includes a chip and an antenna to convert through radio waves. Then the second one, CPU, that is a central processing unit. The microprocessor, otherwise a CPU, is a component that differentiate the smart card from other types of cards that are mainly used to store the data. A microprocessor is in connection through the operating system that allows the smart card to make its own choices regarding where the information is stored within memories and under what condition it must transfer data through its IO interface. The microprocessor includes three main components, such as arithmetic logic unit, that is ALU, then control unit and buses. Then third one, that is memory. So the memory which are employed in these cards are mainly manufactured by using semiconductor materials. These memories include materials of cells that are formed through transistors to store the data. The semiconductor memories which are used in these cards are three types, which include the following. The first one is ROM, that is a read-only memory. Second one, RAM, random access memory. Third one, EEPROM, that is electrically erasable programmable read-only memory. Then memory cards and microprocessor cards. Memory cards contain only non-volatile memory storage components, while microprocessor cards contain volatile memory and microprocessor components. The card is made up of a plastic, generally PVC, but sometimes it is made up of a ABS. When choosing ABS, because of its lifespan, its strength and its higher melting point. The next slide shows the pin details of smart card. So VCC is nothing but a power supply unit. Then RST, user itself, or in combination with an internal reset control circuit. Then clock, that is a clocking or timing signal. Then ground signal. Then VPP, programming voltage input signal. Then IO, input or output for serial data to the integrated circuit inside the card. The use of the two remaining contacts will be defined in the appropriate application standards. That is these two pins, that is a C4 and C8. Then the next slide, that is uses of smart card. So the first use, that is a stored value. The primary use of a smart card is a stored value, particularly loyalty programs that track and incentive repeat customers. Stored value is more convenient and safer than cash. Then second one, securing information. In addition to the information security, smart cards achieve greater physical security of services and requirements, because the card restricts access to all but the authorized user. Then third one, e-commerce. smart card make it easy for consumers to securely store information and cash for purchasing. This type of card can carry personal account, credit and buying preference information that can be accessed with a mouse click instead of filling out forms. Then fourth one, personal finance. That is, customers can use a secure smart card for fast 24-hour electronic fund transfer over the internet. Then healthcare, rapid identification of a patient, improved treatment. For that purpose, this card is used. A convenient way to carry data between system or to site without a system. Reduction of a record maintenance cost. So these are the uses of a smart cards. Then how does the smart card works? That means it at present a smart card are everywhere and they have replaced by magnetic stripe card technology, which has a 300 bytes of a non-rewritable memory capacity. This card includes an embedded ICC. ICC already you know, integrated circuit chip, namely a secure microcontroller. The connection of this card can be done with a smart card reader through direct physical contact, otherwise a contactless radio frequency interface. Then it is connected to the host computer or controller via a card reader, which gets information from the room, information that is a which gets information from the card according to the accordingly passes the information to the host computer or controller. Then it is used to control the data accessing and data manipulation. These cards store a large amount of data because of the embedded microcontroller and communicate with a smart card reader. So this technology obeys the rules of an international standard like ISO or IEC 7816 and ISO or IEC 14443. So it is accessible in different form factors like FOBs, plastic cards, SIM card. SIM card means subscriber identity modules employed in GSM mobile phones and a token based on USB. Then the next one, smart card reader. Smart card does not a function alone and it requires a smart card reader to work properly. This card includes an embedded memory chip that includes a contact pad. When the contact pad is detached from the smart card, then it is no longer smart. So in this card reader, the contact pad approaches in contact through the card reader and carries out the processing. Therefore, it helps you in transaction through the point of a sale, that is a POS, otherwise another medium to perform transactions. But there are two kinds of cards like a contact as well as a contactless card. The utilization of a contactless card is being enhanced quickly because of their convenience to use. The card reader is used to interface with the personal computer for the majority of its processing requirements. Both readers and terminals read and write to smart cards. Readers come in many form factors and in a wide variety of capabilities. Contact smart cards have a contact area comprising several gold-plated contact pads that is about 1 centimeter square. When inserted into a reader, the chip makes a contact with the electrical connectors that can read information from the chip and write information back. This card do not contain batteries. Energy is supplied by the card reader. The working process of this mainly includes the following steps. It is a placed into the card reader to read the data from the card. Once the card reader reads the data from the card, then it passes the data towards the payment system, otherwise authentication system. After that, the payment system, otherwise an authentication system, authenticates the operator whether the information provided by the card matches through the database. Finally, the payment system, otherwise the authentication system, does the necessary task. So this is about a function of the smart card, that is a working process of the smart card. Then what is a smart card reader? Okay, already you know, smart card reader is a device to which the card is connected either directly or indirectly using radio frequency communication. It interfaces with a personal computer or a microcontroller using USB port or RS-232 serial port. It can be contact or contactless reader. Okay, then smart card, that is types of smart cards. So here the types of smart cards are based on a connection to the card reader. The first one is a contact smart card. Then this type of card consists of a electrical contact which are used to connect the card reader where the card is inserted. The electrical contact are deployed on a conductive gold plated coating on the card surface. Contact smart card reader are used as a communication medium between the smart card and a host. For example, a computer, a point of sale terminal or mobile telephone, like that. Since the chips in the financial card are the same as those used for mobile phone, subscriber identify module, that is SIM cards, just programmed differently and embedded in a different shaped piece of PVC. The chip manufacturer are building, manufacturers are building to the more demanding GSM or 3G or 4G standard. Then second type, that is a contactless smart card. This type of a smart card communication with the reader without any physical contact. Rather, it consists of a antenna with which is used to communicate using a radio frequency with the antenna on the reader. It usually receives a power from the reader via electromagnetic signals. Then contactless smart card, in which the chip communicates with the card reader through RFID, radio frequency ID, induction technology. These cards requires only close proximity to the antenna to complete transaction. They are often used when transaction must be processed quickly or hands-free, such as a MOS transit system. Okay, where smart card can be used without even removing them from a wallet. Then third type, cryptographic smart cards. Cryptographic smart cards are often used for single sign-on. Most advanced smart card include a specialized cryptographic hardware that uses algorithms such as RSA and DSA. Then types of smart card based on their functionalities and configuration. It includes a memory card. Memory card means these cards that only consist of memory circuit. It can only store, read and write data to a particular location. The data cannot be processed or manipulated. It can be a striped memory card. That is only used to store data, or a protected memory card with a restricted access to the memory and which can be used to write data. It can also be a rechargeable or a disposable card which contains memory units that can be used only once. Then the next one, microprocessor based cards. So these cards consist of a microprocessor embedded on the chip in addition to the memory blocks. It also consists of a specific sections of files with each file associated with a particular function. the data in files and the memory allocation is managed via an operating system which can be fixed operating system or a dynamic operating system. It allows for data processing and manipulations and can be used for multifunctioning. Then next type, that is a dual interface card. So this card is designed with both interfaces of a contact and contactless. So this kind of card allows a safe access to the chip of the card with either contactless otherwise contact interfaces of the smart card. Then next one, hybrid card. A hybrid card is a design with both the microprocessor and memory. Two different chips are used for different applications which are connected to a single smart card depending on the functionality, because the proximity chip is used to give physical access in prohibited region, whereas the contact chip is used for a sign within authentication. Hybrid cards have a dual capacity which can work both on card reader of contact and contactless. So these types of cards are not frequently used. So these are the types of smart cards available. Then what are the features of smart card? Okay, the first one, that is a feature, that is a smart card embedded with an integrated circuit, then that can process data and provides a number of features like authentication, then a personal device, then a secure data storage, then biometrics, then encryption, secure communications, strong device security. So these are the features of a smart card. Then design process of smart card. The designing steps of the smart card include the following steps. The first step involves designing. The designing involves specifying the chip for the memory size, clock speed, volatile memory types, types of operating system, and specifying the application software. Then specifying the card type, size, functioning, and additional features. Then the second step involves chip fabrication. This involves mounting the silicon chip on an epoxy glass substrate with a gold plated connectors using a die. The silicon chip is bonded to the connectors, connecting wires, that is a wire bonded technique, or using flip chip technology, that is a for solder. The chip on board substrate is then sealed using epoxy resin and glued to the card substrate. The card substrate can be PVC based plastic card or a polyester based card. Then the third step, that is loading the code to the memory using a special command. The fourth step involves data loading into the PROM memory, such as the data pertains to a single person. The data pertains to a single person. So the smart card working process, step number one is a smart card is inserted into the card reader, which reads the information from the smart card. Then after that, the card reader reads the information from the card. It passes the information to the payment system or authentication system. Then step number three, and thereafter the payment system or authentication system authenticated the user whether they provide the data matches with the database. Then fourth step, in the step, the payment system or the authentication system does the required task. So already you know the steps. Then what are the advantages of smart cards? So these are the advantages. The first one, more secure, adaptable administration and control over cash expenditure, then less weight, privacy, portable, particular standards, that is ISO 7811, 7810, 10536 or 9992. Then worldwide acceptance, online. So these are all advantages. Some more advantages, that is 100% efficiency, that is 100% efficient theft proof. Then persistent and protected storage, smart card users can purchase and pay through any things. Then processing power, very comfort for user. Then packaging, simple to use, high memory, information security, in addition with high range of security, upper management information, then reduced scan, then consistency, organized data might be promptly reconfigured, reusable, secure transaction, gives more security, more tough and dependable, permit numerous provisions to be saved in one card, smart card also used in laptops. So at present there are many laptops that are available through smart card reader slot. So this card is placed into a laptop in order to log in by entering the username or password, so that the laptop can be protected from the attack of a single factor authentication, like attacks based on the password, like a weak password, keylogger, and leaked password, and you can define it against a smart card or stolen keys. Then disadvantages. So these are small and less weight. Bank fees are linked with a credit card. Information cannot be retrieved from the stolen card. It needs a smart card reader. It should be recharged. It can be damaged by fluid. Production cost is enhanced. It uses electrical energy to operate. So these are the disadvantages of a smart card. Then applications of smart card. So the most common applications of smart card are credit cards, electronic card, or electronic cash card. Then computer security system, wireless communication, loyalty system like frequently flyer points, then banking, satellite TV, government identification. Mostly in telecommunication, the smart card technology is used. So smart card technology is in the development of SIM card or subscriber identity module. A SIM card provides unique identification to each subscriber and provides the network access to each subscriber and manages its authentication. So this is about telecommunication. Then domestic purpose, these cards are frequently used, that is a DTH smart card. This card provides authorized access to the information coming from the satellites. In simple word, the card with which we can get access to the direct to home TV services is nothing but a smart card. The information is encrypted and decrypted within a smart card. Then e-commerce and retail purpose, this card can be used. This card can be used to store information like a person's account details, transaction details, and can be used in purchasing goods online by acting as a credit card. Some retailer can also use these cards to store points for your particular customers and provide necessary incentives to repeated customers. then banking purpose for this card used. The most prominent use of these cards in banking application is the replacement of the traditional magnetic stripe based credit or debit card. This is an example of MasterCard or a Visa card. Then in government side, that is a smart card or being used by the government to issue identity card to individuals which contains all of the details of the individual. Example, in the recently started Aadhaar card scheme in India. Then secured physical access. Smart card can be used by organization or different public areas to provide authorized access to employee, that is members of the organization or other persons to the secured areas. The smart card generally contains identity details of the individual, which is scanned and checked. Okay, then a working application of a smart card to provide authorized access to secure areas. One of the prominent application of a smart card is storing the identity of the individual. When the person tries to enter a secured area, the data in his or her smart card is checked with the available data in the database. If matched, then the person is allowed access, yes, not. Then the system consists of four main parts. It is generally a contact memory card that contains information about the individual. Then smart card reader is generally a contact smart card reader and is used to read information from the card. A controller which receives data from the smart card reader via RS-232 interface. Then a load, which is a relay in this case, used to drive a motor and connected to the controller via the relay driver IC. The working of the system, that is the individual inserts this card in the card reader. The card reader sends the data to the MAX-232 IC through DB9 connector. Then the microcontroller receives the data from the MAX-232. Accordingly, programmed it to compare, then obtain the information with the stored information in the database. If the data matches, the microcontroller develops logic high as its output pin connected to the input pin of the relay driver circuit. Then relay driver IC accordingly develop a low logic at its output and energizes the relay. The common contact of the relay is now connected to the normally open contact, and the motor connected in series with the relay contact is rotated such that the door is opened. In case the data does not match, the microcontroller is programmed to develop logic low at its output pin, and the relay accordingly does not get energized, so keeping the door shut off. The obtained output is accordingly displayed on the LCD, which shows whether the data is matched or not. So this is the basic overview of the smart card architecture, working design, types and advantages and disadvantages and applications. Smart card is a physical electronic authentication device used to control the data accessing and data manipulation. So it is basically a plastic embedded with an integrated circuit. On the smart card, either a memory card or memory chip or a microprocessor is fabricated to store the data and to connect with the system. So far we have discussed what is a smart card, then architecture of a smart card, pin details, users, then details of a smart card reader, types, features, design process, advantages, disadvantages and applications of a smart card. So the remaining topics we will see in the next topic. next video. Thank you.